Shalom, praise the Lord. Welcome to our brief Bible reflection as we continue encouraging one another, sharing from the book of Isaiah 26, now reading verse 12 to 15. The Bible says, Lord, you will establish peace for us, for you have also done all our works in us. O Lord, our God, masters besides you have had dominion over us, but by you only we make mention of your name. They are dead, they will not live. They are deceased, they will not rise. Therefore, you have punished and destroyed them and made all their memory to perish. You have increased the nations. O Lord, you have increased the nation. You are glorified. You have expanded all the borders of the land. Praise the Lord. Verse number 10 and 11, we saw the Lord speaking about the wicked, that the wicked, even when the hand of the Almighty is lifted, they cannot notice, they are not able to pay attention to his commandments, and they ignore all these. And therefore, if they cannot see the lifted hand of God, you know, the hand that is ready to help and to save God's people, if they cannot see that hand, even the hand of judgment, the Lord declares that they cannot fail to see and acknowledge his wrath. The wicked are said that even when the Lord shows them kindness, they do not even notice. They cannot even notice the majesty of the Almighty. In this portion, we see the prayer of the righteous. The song of the righteous is so different because the righteous are saying, you, Lord, will grant us peace, or you establish peace for us. And all what we have accomplished is really from you, not by our own might. And so the righteous can acknowledge the power of God at work. The righteous can acknowledge God's deliverance. And no wonder they are saying that there have been other masters who had dominion over us, but only by you we continue mentioning your name and singing of your praises. You know, those who served before are dead and gone. You know, the Lord has cleared them. He has made them silent, and they cannot come back anymore because the rule and the reign of our God is eternal. And the people of God continues to say that, oh Lord, you have made our nation great. You know, the righteous cannot fail to acknowledge the doings of the Lord. The righteous cannot brag as though it's all about us. The righteous acknowledges the mighty hand of God, this hand of God that is ready to save his people. They are saying, you have made our nation great. They are acknowledging the intervention of God. You know, you have extended our borders, and we give you the glory. Praise the Lord. You have extended our borders. These people, or the song, because we say this is a song of salvation, they are singing of the greatness of the Lord, meaning that they cannot ignore the power and the presence of God in their lives. And I love what verse number 12 says, that Lord, you will establish peace for us. May the Lord establish peace for you as you dwell in his refuge and under his guidance, as you seek this perfect peace that we talked about in the previous verses. The Lord will surely establish that for you, because for you have done all our works in us. It is God who is at work in our lives. So even concerning that peace that you are longing for, that breakthrough that you are longing for, the Lord is ready to give that unto you. And as the righteous of the Lord, you know, the children of God, we cannot fail to acknowledge God's intervention in our lives. Yes, let us continue singing of his faithfulness, and we shall experience his love in our day-to-day lives, because he is God and surely he will establish peace for us. May he do so for you and your loved one. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shalom.